Today we're going to be testing the 200 EMA plus the parabolic SAR and a MACD crossover, so let's get straight to it. Hi guys, my name is David and this is one of the first videos that I'm going to be doing on testing trading strategies by using code. The idea is I'm going to go through YouTube and find the best trading strategies or supposedly best trading strategies, and I'm going to convert them into code so it can backtest it. And I'm going to put all of these indicators up for free that we make together. I'm going to put them for free on TradingView. You can also join me on my Patreon and Discord group down below in the description. Don't forget to give me a big thumbs up and subscribe. So first things first, let's get straight over to my computer and let's talk about the strategy. Okay, first of all, before I do anything else, welcome back to my computer. Here it is. We're going to be looking at this strategy that I found on YouTube, which is the 70% win rate, highly profitable at MACD parabolic SAR with 200 EMA trading strategy proven over 200 trades. This is from Data Trader, so a great channel as well, so you should go and have a look at that as well before continuing. Right, let's go and have a look at how we coded this thing. Okay, here we are on my computer. So as I said, we're actually going to be using the 200 EMA, the MACD and the parabolic SAR, which we're going to add today by using these indicators here very quickly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you what they all look like and then we'll be coding them ourselves. Right, okay, so as you can see, the PSAR here is giving us the ups and down trends. We're going to be using the 200 EMA. So I'm going to change that to 200 here. Now that's going to give us our trend movement. So we're going to work out whether we're going to be doing buy signals or sell signals. By if we're above the 200 EMA, we're going to be buying only. And if we're below the 200 EMA, we are actually going to be selling or shorting. Then what we're going to be looking for is the MACD crossover, which has to be above the zero line here. So if we're looking for a buy, what would be here would be this crossover here, so a buy signal would actually look something like this over here. We're above the 200 EMA here. We have a buy signal from the PSAR, and we also have a crossover which is below the 100 line. Okay, so we'd actually get in somewhere around, if I go here, around this candle here. Okay, so the idea is now what we're going to do is we're going to take all of that information, we're going to take those three indicators and add them to my boilerplate, and we're going to convert that into a strategy. So I'm going to delete this and I'm going to go through what I've actually done. If you're not interested in the code, this is where you can fast forward a little bit and also give me a like just for the fun. But remember that knowledge is power, and it is a good idea to understand what's actually going on behind the indicator. So let's have a look at that code. Okay, so what I've actually done is I've created the indicator here so you can actually see it. All I'm going to do is show it on there. So if I hide all of these three indicators we added a minute ago, as you can see, I've actually added it all together in one strategy. So let's go through the code together to see what I've done. Okay, first thing I've done is I've gone away and taken the code from the EMA here. So I've pressed this button up here to collect the code, and I've pasted that into my boilerplate. The boilerplate is everything that gives us the bone structure around all of this area here, like the dashboard, the control panel, etc. So if I go down to here, and you can see it says use EMA, and then I've just added that, and I've literally pasted and given it a default value of 200. The only other thing that I actually changed on that was I made the EMA, if I hide the old one there, I've changed the EMA to green color and a red color when it's in a long position green and a red position red. Then I added two variables, which was EMA underscore long and then an EMA underscore short, which will give us a variable whether it's a true or false for those two. I know I could have put that into one variable, but I actually prefer to make it more readable for myself later. Okay, and then the second part of the variable was the MACD. So I literally did the same thing here. I clicked on the code here and I copied all of the code out of here for the MACD. And then I go over here back to the strategy here, and I've pasted that here. Now I've removed all of the coloring and the plotting of the MACD because we can't obviously plot the MACD here when using an overlay strategy. So I've literally taken the information from the MACD, haven't changed anything other than that. And I've also created a MACD cross variable. Now that tells me that the MACD is above or below the zero for longing and shorting. And if that is true, we're looking for a crossover of the MACD and the signal line. So that's the orange and blue line here. And that's going to come back as true or false. And if we're not above or below the zero line, depending on we're looking for a long or a short, it will return false because we don't want to get in a position too late up here at the top where it's crossing and it's already hit the top of the MACD. The last part of the strategy, what I've taken here is the PSAR variables here. So I'm going to click there as well. I literally copied and pasted all of this here except for the study line, obviously, and the version number. So I'm going to go back here and I copied that down here somewhere. There it is. Okay, right. Okay, which has given us the input values, etc., which I haven't moved around. Normally I make it a little bit more tidy, but I didn't do that. And then I did the same thing. I did an out PSAR and I did a underscore short and underscore long. And if it is above, we're looking for a short position. And if it's below, we're looking for a long position. And I've actually plotted them in the same way as the other one. I've actually plotted them in green and red, depending on whether an above price value or below price action. Then part of my strategy obviously is to name all of these areas here so we know where we are with the traffic light system, so that will just makes it more readable for us. And then if you go down, I've done short step 1, 2, 3. Obviously if you go below the EMA before or crossing the MACD, it cancels out. Same with the PSAR, and then we got the long position too. And that's just going to print everything. Now let's have a look at how that did. So as you can see, it's quite a simple strategy, especially in code. It's quite easy to understand. Now what we're going to do is have a look at the strategy and see how well it's done. You have to take all of this with a pinch of salt because you can actually change the way that you take profit. For instance, here's on percentage. You can use ATR with our systems and things like that. But I've also added some tutorials about ATR and also how to change your strategy settings above here in the cards. Okay, that's great. Let's have a look at what the strategy has given us as results. Okay, back at my computer here, I just wanted to show you that it is actually taking the entries at the right place here. We have a crossover on the MACD at the bottom here, which is below the zero. We have our PASAR entry below, which is perfect, and we're above the 200 EMA. So I can now move all of them, and you can see that we're actually taking a percentage a entry here, we're taking our profit up here, and we're having a stop loss here. Right, let's have a look at the settings of this all. As I said, we have added the settings for the actual strategy here. Anything below the enable short entry all the way down to the date here is the actual strategy settings. So you can actually change the source, you can change the length of the 200 EMA. This is the MACD stuff here, and then you have the PSAR here. Okay, so let's have a look at the results of the strategy. I'm just going to shut down the other. Done that, right? Okay, so we're going to click here, click strategy tester, and this is our default setting. So we can actually improve this by changing maybe the stop loss, etc. We have 108% return on our investment over, when was our first entry? First entry would have been in February, so quite a while ago. Was it even this year? Yes, it was this year, so February. And we have 40% profitability. So obviously, as I keep saying, you can change the settings in here. We could go for maybe changing the settings to a ATR here, which would decrease our stop loss. Hold on, if we go here, ATR, sorry, stop loss, and then put our fixed profit here, but that would decrease our stop loss, and that's taking it down to 52% at 36% profitability. So let's have a look if we can keep changing these about. In the strategy, I believe that he used higher highs and higher lows for stop loss, etc. So we're up to 50% here. Now let me make sure we have 6 here and on the ATR. If I put that to 1 and that to 1. Okay, it hasn't changed much of the strategy itself. Okay. ATR here. Okay, so now I've changed that to the ATR here. We could actually change that to the higher highs or higher lows. I believe that's the strategy he was using. We could change our probability for profit factor risk to reward to 2 here. That would give us a 72% return on investment and 39%. We can look back less number. Well, the look back, actually what that does is it tells you how many candles it's going to look back to find the higher high. I put 20 here and 20 here. Now that's giving us a better profitability, lower profitability, but a higher profit. Okay, I've now finished the coding of that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to continue modifying and improving it. I'll put it up for free on TradingView, so you can install it on your charts. And we can come and discuss with me on our Discord group, your strategies, etc. And maybe I'll code them for you. Okay, guys, have a great day. If you did enjoy the video, please don't forget to thumbs up and subscribe. You can also join me on the Patreon page, and I'm wishing you a great day, and don't forget to keep coding, keep safe, guys. Have a good day. Goodbye.